please welcome Chic singing Good Times.
Let's get together. How about a quarter to ten? Well, hello and welcome. It's Sunday. You know what that means. It's time for me to adjust my microphone during the intro. And it's time for Sunday Scaries. This is a little different this week. Thank you for joining us. A couple things you may not know that you should know. First off, we are also live on Facebook this week, just on my personal page. So, hello, probably. Distant relatives I haven't talked to in a while. It's so great when you just immediately learn the bad part of an idea. When you're live and you're already doing it. I have no idea who's watching this. So hello. Hello all of you. We are in the middle of two things. We're in the middle of the Super Bowl, which if you didn't know, you were kindly alerted to that the halftime show is coming up shortly, and you all are welcome to jump off and go do that in 1 minute of football time. But we are also in the middle of the Steam Games Festival. Let's see, every time I mispronounce it and call it the Steam Games Festival, go ahead and take a drink of your non-alcoholic beverage of choice. I have no idea who the halftime show is. Who could possibly care? I'm here doing this. What else, like, why would you watch anything else? It's the weekend. That was a great bit. I was very proud of that. So, the Steam Games Festival is basically a chance for developers to show off what they're working on for games that aren't out yet. If you saw the posts about the false start stream on Wednesday, that's what I meant. We're playing a bunch of games that aren't done yet. Games that don't really exist. And if you want to know what those games could be, there's a place you can do that. There's also a place where you can vote on how much you like the games that we are playing. If you hit exclamation point tears in the chat, very good. It's the weekend. Yes, exclamation point tears in the chat. I don't know why I'm doing this now. Everybody go watch the halftime show. You can go to tiermaker.com, which is where we're going to be doing this. And then every time we play a game today, we're going to find its little... We're going to come over here. We're going to find the icon for the game. And we're going to see where it fits in this tier. And then we are going to use this tiering system to determine whether or not we play these games when they actually get released. That's what we're doing today. I threw Cardboard Kings in here as a B because that's the first thing we're going to play. Cardboard Kings is a simulator game based on running a friendly local game store. So I'm going to turn the volume of this up because I had it turned down while doing stream prep. You should be getting a little of that background noise. And we are just gonna burn through these games. So if I'm playing something and you don't like it, let me know, and then we can swap it around. If you are wondering about what we might wanna play next, exclamation point tears, you can look through those little icons. Those are all games that we can possibly play today, including ice cream truck, including Timberborn. Ice Cream Truck's a game about an ice cream truck. Timberborn, a game about a colony of beavers after the apocalypse. They're the only ones left. They have to rebuild society. Where did it go? Where'd the good one go? Did it not make it on there? Oh no! Also, Inspector Whiskers. Which seems to not be on there. Oh, Inspector Waffles. Yes, we can also play Inspector Waffles, don't forget. But for now, and especially while some of you are going to screw off and go watch the halftime show, we're going to run a friendly local game shop, Harry's Card Shop. This is one of the games I've played a little bit. There are many I have not played at all yet. So, looks like we should talk to our bird here. Good day, big boy squawk. It's Giuseppe. My name's Giuseppe, see? Your father and I run this place together. Well, we ran this place together. No use dwelling on it. We gotta get this card shop reopened. Wait, you can talk? Let's do that. Wow, just wow. It's 2020. You know? Fair. Hey, I'm just having fun with you. Haha. Alright, get down to business. Listen up, Squark. You need to get more cards to sell in this shop. Have a look in the newspaper for any card types that will increase in value. Then use that computer over there to buy some cards. Okay. Newspaper. Yellow warlock cards caught in storm. In 2 days, yellow colored cards will increase in value. Alright. Let's go to our card listings here. Now we are looking for yellow cards. We want to buy yellow cards. That could be orange. We'll come back. We also have $20, it looks like, down here. $20. My little tear bubble is not helpful right now, so let's throw that somewhere. We're actually just gonna get rid of that for now. Oh no. Alright, Warlock. So this must be our yellow then. We've seen it twice now. Big eggs boosters. So we could buy a pack of cards too. So Netscape, thank you. I was thinking it was Congregate, but I knew that wasn't right. I focused on the K instead of the logo. So yes, that is a very good Netscape knockoff. So let's go ahead and we'll buy that yellow card. And then we will buy this yellow card. And yeah, we'll buy a booster pack as well. We'll might play some risks here. So we've got $12, $2 shipping out of our 20. Yeah, let's do that. All right, payment successful. Buying cards. Okay, started playing Yu-Gi-Oh! With a kid at church, so this is very relevant. I assume you mean recently and not when we were children, correct? All right, what do you need from me, Giuseppe? It's teaching time, Squark. You need to put cards up for sale to make money. Sorry, that's how the world works. Speaking of, Doug Coin currently at 0.072, down from its high earlier today. Sorry, that's how the world works. Open your collection on the left and find a card with high market price. Already, I'm seeing like a lot of like messy UI stuff. And again, this is a demo. So we're gonna find a card that has a high market value, $7. Is that our big one? Yeah. And let's put it on display in our friendly local game shop. Would you like to buy a card? Don't leave. Okay. Let's throw some more cards out there, though. Ooh, that card we're not going to put out because that's a yellow. And those are going to go up in value because we read it in the newspaper that is printing front page stories about magic cards, apparently.
Sorry, warlock cards.
Hello. Oh, do you have a question? Hey, that Skeletotem would fit great into my new deck. Would you sell it for 25 cents? Let's see if we can't get a price on a Skeletotem. Yeah, I would sell that for 25 cents. That's roughly what it's worth. Great. This is just what my deck needs. Orb warning, what was that no for? Was I not supposed to sell that for 25 cents? Or not supposed to put the yellow card on sale? It looks like some rascally vagabonds have been bunking in here as of late. And they didn't realize there's a toilet out back. Oh no, rascally vagabonds pooping in the store. You might want to clean up. How do I clean up though? Oh, I click on garbage. I mean, that is clearly banana peel. There we go. Oh, that's obnoxious. Get it together. Oh, there's a cobweb. Oh, do I have to click it that much to clean it? Wow. Okay, so the door closed. Are we done for the night? What's... turn in for the night. Not true. My friendly local game shop in Fort Wayne was run by a woman, and it was about, I'd say, 60-40. Okay, we got a 15% chance for rush hour. Oh, let's talk to this guy. Yo, Harry Squawk. Occasionally, customers will call on that phone, to request a specific card. Requesters say to them, when you have the card they want, drop it on the matching request to get paid. Okey-dokey. Oh, no one's called yet. There we go. Here's our... oh, no! In and out. That's not ideal. Let's throw some more cards out, I guess. I don't know if those have gone up yet, though. Get swamp out there. It's a land card. Yes, sir. Oh, perfect. That guy bought a swamp, and we just threw another swamp out there. Uncle Robot, also, I would like you to report back and let me know how the halftime show was. if I didn't think I would just immediately get kicked off the internet, we would just throw it on. Yeah, buddy. You're also wondering what all the symbols on those cards mean. Actually, yeah. The number in the bottom left of this Gankar card is its power. I don't see a number on the bottom left. X. Its ability is a sword. Yeah, I do. Okay, which set it belongs to? Got it. It's rare. You can tell by the gold details. Okay. Oh yeah, it's got a gray vine pattern. Sure. It is less fancy, that common. Oh, yeah. Nah. Shiny effect. Yeah. We love a shiny. Let me know if you would like me to just turn this into a... this whole stream into a Pokemon opening stream. It seems to be very popular right now. Yes, sir. We do trades. No. What a bad trade. This Takalashi is only worth 120, and this Corrupted is worth 290. No, thank you.
bummer. Maybe next time, hey?
And Uncle Robot, this shop is on the beach because it's in Australia, and I think all things are on the beach in Australia. I think it's the rules. So we got two requests. We need a shiny card. Two shiny cards. We have any shiny cards right now. No, we don't. But can we find some shinies online? Maybe we can buy a shiny. None of those look shiny. Oh, so this is a Roman numeral. So that was a 10, not an X. There we go, here's some shinies. Let's buy these guys. Yeah, buy all the shinies you have. And another booster. Gotta love some boosters. Oh, did I not check out? Oh, beans. I'll spend all of my money, essentially. And then what other card should we put out before we go to bed for the night? So also, we haven't figured out what this system is going to be like, but if we're at a point where you, like, get the game and want to move on to something else, just start making some noise in chat, and we'll see. I think we can go ahead and put the yellows out, because it's been 2 days. So by the time the store opens tomorrow, those should be more expensive. And we'll be able to sell them right away. It is fully Australian, you can tell, because their dollars are called dollary dues. Yeah, and look, those cards went up, and we are going to flip those tomorrow, hopefully. Let's make some money. Let's make some money on some cards. Also, Uncle Robot, who is your, who's your whole clan pulling for over there? Who's Sebastian and Rupert? Got in the game here. Yes, sir. Hi there, you must be Harry. This guy is not wearing shoes in my store. I must be. I want to come and give my condolences for your father's passing. He was an old friend. I guess you don't remember me. Truly the worst thing you can say to a person is, I guess you don't remember me. But also, let's just take a second to, like, take in this guy's whole vibe. Christopher, your dad helped set up the shop. Back when he was world champ, you both played Warlock. Harry is the Giuseppe now. Christopher invented Warlock. His name's on every pack. I could say, I was being ironic, or ooh, me dumb. I think we have to go ooh, me dumb. Whoa, don't pin it all on me, Giuseppe, haha. Harry, if you're anything like your father, I'll have to card battle you sometime. Yes, card battle. A thing I definitely know about. Haha, a joker just like your father. That's great. Anyway, I'm back in Parakeet Bay for a while. I'll pop in when I can. See ya, boys! Buy my cards. Buy it. Oh, I do have new price tags. They're a good way to increase your reputation. We're gonna bid more money on some cards. Okay. And a staff pick card that we are gonna put on this guy. Buy my cards. That's one of those yellows. Rush hour. I don't have any cards out. No, I almost sold out of cards here. We do trades. Skeletotem, 90 cents for that Orc Butcher, 90 cents. But I'm out of Skeletotems. Yeah, sure. No problem, Devo. Ripper, seeing mate. Yes, buy that card. I don't want my reputation went down. Is it because I don't have any cards out?
Barry.
What's cracking?
I wish this weather would let up. Always true.
Here you go.
Oh, there's another yellow. Let's see if I can't get that out. Oh, right. These are the yellows I bought. They're now all worth more. Oh, and a booster pack. Let's pop open this booster. We got a Hive Queen, a Midnar First Warlock, and a Takalashi. Takalashi 69, am I right? Nice. Nice. My shinies haven't arrived yet. Okay, how do I close this now? We got a calendar for some reason. Jacqueline's arriving, visiting tomorrow. I got mail arriving, and Mind Shuffle's increasing. Yeah. Let's not sell a Mind Shuffle before then. These yellows out. What's the news say? Keanu loves Warlock, especially Mind Shuffle. Keanu Reeves. Warlock is breathtaking. You guys want to know what my favorite card is? I'm guessing it's Mind Shuffle. Can we buy a Mind Shuffle now? Yeah, let's buy that Mind Shuffle. Let's buy that shiny. Very on brand for Keanu. To just randomly tweet one day. Why did the music stop? Oh, is it because the store is closed? Possibly. We have no more cards to put out. All of our cards are out, which is fine. And then let's do a... I don't really want to put any of the... We really missed our shot on that card. All right, let's go to the next day. Oh, no. Go back. Okay, now let's go to the next day. We earned $21 redos that day. We got three new cards. Could not be more excited about it. Okay, I think I will give each game like a hard half hour limit no matter what, so we're probably coming up on that with this game. Okay, come on, mail. Come on, mail person. Don't steal my card. Okay. I thought that person was going to steal my cards. I just need more cards to put out. Yes, what's cracking? Any mail today? Sure, here you go. Booster pack. What do we get? Incorruptible. Neferasi suggestion. Shiny. Unfinished Warrior Shiny. That's got to be $8 right there. I'm going to say we made our money back on that one. And then these are the ones that we need for buying. All Shinies. Shinies all the way down. We did okay. What's up, boyo? What's the crake? I'm Declan. Declan O'Regan. Where's Ant? I'm from the Commonwealth Card Retailers Union, and I'll be popping in once a week to see how you're doing. We set weekly goals and reward you with decorations. That's what unions do, right? Well, sure. Anyway, have a decoration on the house. Nice, a grass creature statue. Why don't you select next week's goal? Ooh, I went on a skull camera. Let's go. If you want to take out your store, slap that paintbrush over there. Cool. Let's get some of these cards out there, though. No, where'd you go? No rush hour today. A true bummer. There is no rush hour today. Oh, shiny cards. Oh no, okay, yes. Let's do a shiny card for you. And then let's do a shiny card for you also. Hey, check out this Hallowed Ground I won in a game last night. I'll sell it to you for $1.45. Yeah, that works. It's $1.60. Sorry that we're ripping you off a little bit, but... Oh, we got another... We got more requests now. A card in mint condition. How do I know that they're in mint condition? Oh, you have another? An uncommon or rare yellow card. Do we have any of those? That's boring. Yeah. Oh, we are very close to our weekly goal. I know I'm a little in the way there. All right, we'll do one more day, and then we'll move on to a different game. 7 new cards, 1 new decoration, $23.3. $13 chance of rush hour. Defensive condemned due to satanic implications. And 3 days cards with the ability defensive will increase for value. Hi, Obama Robot Voice. We are currently playing through some demos from the Steam Game Fest. This is a game where you run a local, friendly local game store that appears to only sell knockoff Magic cards. This card is definitely not in mint condition. It's got a fold right across it. No rush hour today. Dang it. What else you got? What other requests? A card from the set Warlock the Beginning. We're taking care of special orders. We hit our weekly goal. Buy something, please. Oh, do you have a question? I love helping people. Oh, you do? Okay. Hello, sir. Oi, my friend Blake reckons he made a real good deck, but I think mine would smash it. Could you take a look at the two and let me know which one would you reckon would win? We know nothing about this game so far. Okay, so... We got Age of Empires, great name, versus Ultra 17. I think I go melee Age of Empires just because there's so much more attack. Yeah. Great. Great day, though. Glad I could help. Oh, I gotta... All right, I think with that, we are gonna bounce back over to our tier list and call that for Cardboard Kings for the day. So right now we've got Cardboard Kings at a B. I think it makes sense to keep it there. Actually, I'm gonna bump it up to A. That could be an A level game. If you hit exclamation point tiers in the chat, you can get your own one of these if you wanna play along at home. You can also help us pick what we are going to play next. I think now is the time, unless anybody has any suggestions, I think now is the time that we play Inspector Waffles. So we'll get Inspector Waffles up there and start figuring out what Inspector Waffles has for us today. So if you'll bear with me for just a moment. Get the demo for Inspector Waffles up and running. I'm gonna give Cardboard Kings an A If you have any other thoughts, let me know. But we are gonna play. You wanna load for me? Yeah, it's time for Inspector Waffles. Ladies and gentlemen, again, a game coming soon. We got a B from Orb Warning. I will go ahead and adjust, especially now because we're just throwing stuff around. I will adjust hardworking down appropriately, but let's play Inspector Waffles. Oh, what a sad cat already. Oops, I broke it. There we go. We got Patches calling in. What is this, a P.D. Pablo song? Urgent. Trigger warning depression. Sorry, the audio, I keep adjusting the audio down because it feels really loud. It's also not, it's annoyingly not centered in the stereo mix. Inspector Waffles, let's go. What if that's the whole demo though? Chapter 1, The Dead and Alive Cat. Midnight in Cat Town, and I'm headed to a new crime scene. Why do I still do this job? I could be anywhere right now, chilling on the beach, sipping a piña colada. But no, I'm out here working day and night for this town. Don't be a hero. My mother, she wanted me out of this life, a quiet office job with decent working hours. And I should have listened. Mom's always right. An inspector's life is a dangerous one. But if there's one thing I like more than strong milk, it's solving mysteries. Let's go. So far, S tier, perfect game. Inspector Waffles on the scene, and I'm looking like a stray cat as usual. That's Patches saying that. My fault, Chief Patches. I'm afraid I wasn't expecting to be working tonight. Tell me, who's the victim? The victim. His name was Fluffy, the boss of Box Furniture. Oh, I love their boxes. Don't we all, Waffles? So, did he off himself? Doubtful, but we can't rule it out at this stage. We've been waiting for you to sniff out the truth. Giving me too much credit there, Chief. Do you see the lady cat at the front gate? No. Why? She's a friend of the victim, came by earlier to see our dead friend here. She rang his doorbell and no one answered, but someone jumped over the fence and vanished into the dark. Someone. She says she only saw a shadow, but she says whatever it was big. Okay, I'll have a look around the house first. These are yellow, like I'm supposed to click them, but I'm not. Then we can chat with her once we're done here. No problem, take as long as you need. Small problem though. Interesting. We haven't been able to access the top floor. Can we kick the door down? He's dead. He won't complain. Not until we have clearance from the higher ups. If you can find a way to get up there without damaging the property, that'd be great. Let's do some cat stuff. If you can't, don't forget you have a very valuable resource in your pocket. Valuable resource? Yes. A brilliant ex-inspector, able to help you at any moment. I'm not asking my mother for help, Patches. Yes, she was great, but I don't need her. I can solve this case all by myself. Well, if you change your mind, just check your notepad. She probably left one of her little notes. I told her not to do that anymore. Mind you, she never listened to me before either. Anyway, I'm gonna head inside and have a look around. Oh, it is a point and click, okay. I clicked on Fluffy's body. This dead cat is the reason why I'm here. Let's see if there's anything in his pockets. A Polaroid picture. A cat at the beach with a red lighthouse behind him. no idea who the cat is. Maybe it's a clue? No clue found. It was not a clue, apparently. Okay, chill out. Now let's go inside the house. Figurine is a sculpture from a long time ago. Probably 9th century Southern Doggo, if I'm not mistaken. Just call me Laura Crufts. What a dumb joke. Nah, just kidding. I know nothing about archaeology. Vase? An old vase. It looks very fragile. I kind of want to break it. I mean, I won't. But my animal instincts are kicking in pretty strong right now. So many good cat bits. Bridge. I don't know where this bridge is located, but it seems to be a great place to live. What a bonkers reaction. Okay, nice bedroom. Being rich definitely has its perks. To me, this is like too... I don't like the art style, is what I'll say. It's a great bit, though. Another great bit. Okay, we got a cup. Oh, Fluffy was a semi-pro wool ball player in his youth. Wow. That explains the wool ball outside. Interesting. There's a letter inside the cup. Oh, no. My tiger, I can't wait until the next time I hear you roar. Tenderly, M. Seems Fluffy had a lady cat in his life. I should find out who she is, or you should mind your own business. I'm confused. Okay, just chill out. Skateboard. This is a very old skateboard. Looks like it was discarded here. One wheel seems to be broken. I'm going to take it. I can find some use for it later. Oh no. Oh no. I broke it again. We're back. Picture. Back in the day, Fluffy was quite an elegant cat. He was rich, classy, smart, but despite all that, alone. Wow. Actually, there aren't any pictures of his family or friends in this entire house. Maybe Fluffy wanted to forget something about his relatives? Question mark. New clue. Fluffy was alone. Wow, great clue. It's a famous painting from Meow Greet. They did it, ladies and gentlemen. Oh, it's a hideout. That looks cool. Hidden book. Only a book here. Nothing of much value. Look at the book, you dummy. I probably never will, but it was hidden, so I guess I should take it. I don't know any of these bands. Maybe I need to get out of my office from time to time. Okay, I think we're good here. Did I miss anything? Stereo skateboard. I can't open this door. The handle is missing. This is a sculpture from a long time ago, probably 9th century. Oh, did we already look at this one? Yeah. Okay. Yeah, okay. I don't really want to go back outside. Oh, here we go. We found another door. It's a bathroom. Hairbrush. No idea how to use this object. Very good. Litter box. Not going to check for clues in a litter box. I don't hate myself enough for that. Wow. Tile. There's a little hole in this tile. There's something on the other side. Maybe if I give it a pull. Oh, I forgot to update my stream info here. Let's do that real quick. We are playing. What is this, Inspector? Waffles? Yeah. We are playing Inspector Waffles. Great, update it. Maybe if I give it a pull. Oh no, a hideout. Shout out to all the oh no hats. It's a hidden book. Why is there a book in here? This guy just is ashamed of reading. Maps of Kazakhstan, 18th century. Heyo. Who's interested in books like this? Nerds. Le Petit Chaton Parisien. I need to work on my French. A Lady's Fragrance by Yves Saint Laurent. So cliche. Why would Fluffy have female perfume? Someone else must have left it in here. Perhaps it belongs to Fluffy's lover. Or maybe Fluffy just likes to smell nice. New clue! Lady's perfume in Fluffy's bathroom. Litter box, hall. That's where we got to the hall, I guess. Wait, I didn't check the medicine cabinet. What am I doing? What kind of detective am I? Okay, I think we saw everything there. I think we go back outside now. Check the bedroom. This door's still locked. Because the handle is missing. Ball of wool. Fluffy knew how to have fun. I'm not going to play with it, even if I really want to. Fluffy knew how to have fun. Oh, I already clicked it. Trash can. Let's go through the trash. A cat searching through trash cans. I'm such a cliche. Stop saying cliche challenge. Nothing special inside except for this broken screwdriver. Waffles, I forgot. If you want to see more about an item in your inventory, you can right-click on it. I don't know exactly what that means, but I bet it's useful for learning more. But if you're just picking up trash during your investigations, maybe not so much. Rude. Okay, is this all just stuff that we knew already? Anyone who enjoys history or geography would love this. Interesting. Personally, I prefer comics. Definitely an alley cat. I want to know if we can... Welcome back! How was the halftime show? Use the screwdriver! Use the screwdriver to open the broken door! How is this difficult? There we go. There we go! Real gamer stuff. But I can't turn it. It's too slippery. What if we put the skate wheel on it? Yeah, I made a door handle because I know how games work, baby. Very proud of myself. Okay, every rich guy has his own library. That's what they always say. And it doesn't contain even a single comic book. What are we doing? Books. Classic and popular books written by cats. One of the books is missing. Oh, no. Oh, if I put this book, my blue book there. Yeah. You already did it. Heard a little click, but nothing else happened. Okay, so now red book. Yeah, red book. A secret door! I wish I could afford to have one put in my place. It's surprisingly... not that bad. You just need a big bookshelf and your friend Andy to help you move it. But why hide access to an entire floor of your home? This case is going to be really interesting. Is that the end of the demo? I would end the demo when I click this. Oh no, we got more. A secret office? What was he hiding in here? Who knows? One of my favorites. Well, cats need this for comfort. Most of us want to stay clean and healthy. I, on the other hand, just want a glass of strong milk. Here's a hair stuck on one of these branches. Okay. Got a hair. Computer. No disk found. Everything was recently erased. Never a good sign. Papers. Something interesting here, buried amongst all these papers. Someone's written, I can't keep hiding these two books every time. you know, a fair point. I would like a door that I can open electronically, quickly, and easily. Can you do that for me? Thanks. Unfortunately, there's no delivery name or address. It's on the board, only a single piece of paper left. Mouse tails, duck grease, salmon. It's a grocery list. Fluffy clearly enjoyed good food. But why is there a grocery list pinned up in his office? Seems like something that should be in the kitchen. I don't like when I don't understand. I'm taking it with me. You know, fair. Window. I saw this broken window from the outside. Someone pushed him out of the window. The defenestration of this cat. It's strengthened glass. Whoever did this was very strong. Haven't got time to start a puzzle. There's always time for a puzzle. There are plenty of useless papers. Electric bills, installation CD, piano lesson, an insult letter. Wait, what? Someone named Irwin sent this letter just a week ago. And curiously, among all the other barbs, a platypus. I didn't know it could be used as an insult. It ends with a signature, Irwin. We knew all that already. Blood? Blood drops. Fluffy was probably dead before falling from the top floor. That explains why he didn't land on his paws. I'm sure he was murdered. I still don't know the reason. Let's check out the bathroom. Is this the same bathroom? Oh. Okay, so this is the same bathroom. But now can I not get back in? Okay, I can't. Secret office. We've seen everything. Let's go back to the library. Dog slang. Dog accents across the world. It's all about dogs here. Interesting. Why would a cat have a dog section? These books are about evolution. When we learned to walk on two paws a long time ago. Is a cat walking on two paws, you know? Already added a book. I think we're done here. Go back out to the hall. Let's go back outside. Let's go talk to this guy. Top floor. Waffles, did you find a way to get to the top floor? Please feel free to use me to interrogation practice. Talk to me like you would any other person of interest. As you explore, you'll gather items and write down clues. Yep.
Okay.
Oh, what's my clue? There we go. We found a secret office on the top floor, Chief. A lot of blood, too. We need to get forensics up there. Do you think the murderer knew about the office? Could he have gotten in on his own? It's hard to say. Could have been invited in or just knew how to gain access. He's like a vampire. Looks like this is turning into quite the case, Waffles. Seems that way, yes. And nothing about it is going to be cut and dry. Try to be a bit more optimistic, Waffles. We've solved our fair share of tricky cases in the past. I don't think now is the time for optimism, Chief. There's a dead body 5 feet from where we're standing. Perhaps you're right. We can celebrate once we've solved the case. Something salty. Where's the witness, Chief? In front of her house on the street. Uncle Robot, I'm waiting to see what you're conditioned to respond as. So what are we waiting for? We're waiting on that. We just talked about it. Let's go and ask her some questions. Give me a minute. I need to finish my milkshake first. Seriously? That's the most important thing right now? really can't think straight until I've had my milkshake. Let me enjoy it slowly, Waffles. Don't you go ruining it like you did last time! Talking about salty foods while I'm drinking a milkshake, what is happening? Respect the shake, Waffles! I mean, I'm gonna mention a salty thing. Sorry, buddy. Wait, what am I trying to do now? I'm gonna call my mom and see what happens. Ring, ring. Come on, mom. Hello? Hi, mom. It's me. My little Waffles. How you doing? I'm fine. Okay, I'm skipping all of this. You're losing me, Waffles. Oh, so you do want me to. Oh, that was actually helpful. But why won't you let me talk about something salty? You won't let me click it. You are missing something. Oh, there we go. That was weird. But I want to ruin it. Did I miss something inside? Like, there's no kitchen. All right. I'm over it. We are going to pump back to our tier list here. We are going to figure out where we put Inspector Waffles. That's the great thing about demos. We don't have to play them for long. I am inclined I'll maybe put Inspector Waffles on top of Cardboard Kings. Again, if you want to play along, it's exclamation point tiers in the chat. You will then be able to go to save download, and that uploads your tier list, and then we can view community rank, which is how we're going to decide what we play in the future. Dogecoin currently at 0.076. Just the updates that you need. What should we play next? I think, let's scroll back down here. We got some more cat action. We still got Meow Pow and Nine More Lives to play. Timberborn, I think, looks interesting. Skatebird might be our next best bet. Also, there's a circus game. Also, Caddy and Batty. Casino Tycoon, 100 Days, Festival Simulator. Let's do Escape Simulator. If you want to help plan what's next, again, feel free to go through that list at any point. Where did we say Escape Simulator was? Here it is, sorry. And then let me just punch in Escape Simulator. Oh, Timberborn or copy editor. Sure, we'll do those. Sorry, the delay. You got sucked up in the delay here. Let's try copy editor. I think it's going to be a mess, just from what I've seen up to this point. But where are you?
Okay. So this, it just really throws you into it. We'll give it a second to see if it's gonna load in on its own. It is not, which means I have to... What if there was a Tipper Gore game? That'd be wild. Okay. Come on now. Oh, wrong thing. Okay, copy editor, for some reason, not loading in. We're gonna give it one more second, and then we will. Yes, I'm all about that version of that game. It's gonna be tricky though, if you're allowing intergender fighting. You really have to do the messaging around that correctly. Or what we like to call the pro wrestling problem. All right, copy editor, we did our best. For some reason, you did not load. It's not your fault. We think you're probably still a great game. Let's try Timberborn. Play Timberboard demo. Yes, please. Drum rolls. You are now playing Timberborn pre-access, pre-early access demo. Meant to give you a glimpse of the full game. Certain gameplay features are locked out. Demo is in English. Preview demo. Be prepared for bugs. Beta save games are not supported, which is not a problem. Okay, choose our faction. We got the Beavers of Demoria or the Iron Teeth. Oh, Iron Teeth are not available in this demo, so that one's easy. But I would have picked... I would have picked the Iron Teeth, but also, how cute is this? No, we're gonna start on the plains, the real flat terrain large. Of. Oh, Timberborn. What? Just an incredibly good. Incredibly good stretch. Also, how was the halftime show? Okay. Every thriving settlement starts with getting some logs. Use the bottom action menu, just down here, to build a log pile and mark trees for cutting. Okay. Okay, so let's cut down all of these trees. But then how do I build a log pile? Somebody go cut those trees down. Log pile. Okay, so now they have... Go, little beavers. Found trouble with a friend already has this ranked as an A, and the halftime show is pretty good. Apparently, literally flashy. There's how we zoom in. Look at this little beaver. What are you doing? What do you mean there's no log pile in range? In range of what? Compared to what? How do I move you? Ugh. I'm not frustrated. You're frustrated. Oh, there we go. Now do you want to build the log pile? How do we get rid of this one? Delete. Okay. Go! Look, they're eating the trees! Are they eating the trees? They are. They're using their hands. These cute little beavers. Hi, guys. What do you mean no log pile in range? I put a log pile right there. Okay, continue. I did it. Now let's keep the beavers alive. Great plan. Build a water pump on the riverbank. To secure a steady supply of water, you should place a gatherer flag to gather berries from the nearby bushes. Oh, over here. Okay, done. Oh, they have to build them. You know, fair. Why is this thing blinking at me? I have three beavers that are jobless. Jeepers. So this is also really interesting, and I know it's very tiny on your screens. But normal, like, I think in most games, this would be like a pause, a play sign, a fast forward sign, and then a super fast forward. But they've gone with 0x, 1x, 3x, and 7x. I wonder if that won't change. But it is helpful to know. But who's gonna... What are we waiting on here? Oh, entrance is blocked. Okay. I mean, that's... I'm so angry. Ah! Okay, we did it. Now let's get another storage log pile. Let's not put it right there. Okay, rebuild. Also, thank you for the heads up. No longer playing Inspector Waffles, now playing Timberborn. Sure. Now playing Timberborn. Thank you for the heads up. No log pile in range? Put a log pile there! Somebody make a log pile! Go get me logs! Look at how cute they are, though. They are carrying them, like, oh.
Well, that's delightful.
Put them in. Yes! Log piles, log piles, log piles. Let's go. Build a water pump. Also, capitalism is bad. But also, worker beavers get to work. Alright, so we're going to speed up time, because we can do that. Ooh, it's nighttime now. All beavers take naps. We have a good amount of berries, though. We don't have any water. This could be a problem. All right, so here they go. Little worker. The worker beavers. Building a water pump. Eating trees. They don't really eat trees, but... Okay, we did it. Continue. Building a small water tank in the center of your village will make it easier for the beavers to quench their thirst. Bam! How about that water tank? Catch me outside. How about that water tank? Jeff Bezos was running the show, all those trees would be down by now. Very true. But I don't know. It would suck. It would be bad. None of these workers would be getting paid. Their families would. Yeah, I don't want to talk. I can't even do Jeff Bezos bits. They're too much of a bummer. Build this water tank. Jeff Bezos does have a button that makes people work 7 times faster than they normally would, though, and it's called the threat of being fired because he's a garbage person. There we go. We figured it out. We got to the bit. See, Uncle Robot... You got great setup. Sometimes it just takes me a while to get around to knocking him down. You know, knocking him down. Build that water tank. Why is this so slow? But, like, seriously, no, I do not want to do that. All I want is this water tank. I'm also not being a jerk. I could crank this up to 24 hours, but I don't think we have enough beavers to get that done. Oh, you missed it down here, but one of the beavers has grown up, which is exciting. Oh, water tank's done. We did it. Dirt path extends the range of buildings in your village. All right, I can build the dirt path. What up, Parkitect, essentially? But why is that the art for building a dirt path? It is the opposite of what I wanted. We haven't really looked around yet at all to this weird world we're living in. Oh, but I like these guys so much. Like, oh. They all have names! This is Hiptu! This is my new friend, Ubazur! Oh no. Is this gonna... Like, maybe this is gonna be the game. Who are you? Hi! Come back, friends! Hello, who are you? Yawan! Oh, it's 4 days old, Yawan! Hi! Kaya! What does this guy have it at? July! Working on a tree for me. Oh, I know their names now. Shout out to all the old heads who were here when we had to stop playing the, when we had to stop playing the dog racing game because I got sad. Hello, sir. Zebajin! Hi, Zebajin. Lives in a sleeping mat, works at Lumberjack Flag. Oh no, this is the cutest game in the history of the world. Hello? Ubazur, oh, is still out here working so hard, Hiptu. They're a real power team. Oh man. Oh no. Oh no. What are you doing, guy? Where are you going? Oh, you're gathering berries. Let's build you a path so you can do that easier. It's not a word, I don't care. But how do I build more paths? There we go. There you go, use that path, walk faster. Oh, there he goes. It's got a little faster. No big deal. No big deal. Their little accents. I wonder what language they speak. I think we all agree that this is cute. That's the tutorial. They should now be able to survive for a while because we have water and we have paths for them. This guy. Oh, we need a path here too. So one of the things that I've been trying to figure out for this stream is like what if I was going to decide, especially for not Sunday Scaries, like for some of these Wednesday streams that we do, if I was just going to pick like a genre of game, what is the most interesting genre of game for me specifically up to this point? And I really think it is this kind of, like, economic simulator kind of thing. Just because, you know, it's creative in the way we like. It gives some flexibility. There's not really an end goal for a lot of this. Oh, this, look at this chunk! Rotsack! It's 50% fertility. Look at his cute little face, though. Oh, and then you can just follow them around, I bet. Yep, we're just gonna stay focused on Rotsack for a second. What are you doing, buddy? Looking around. True hero. True hero stuff. Average well-being is a 3. Everybody's doing good there. Let's build. What can we build here? Ooh, let's farm. Maybe we want to build a farm.
make a little farm. There is. That is not. SimCity 2000 might be a little tricky, but we can definitely play old games. They don't fit into the. It is one of the bummers about. I wish there were demos for old games that we could still play, because this demo structure works really well, I think. All right, I think we've now got the idea of, look at all these logs they put together. I think we've basically got the idea for Timberborn. A great suggestion. Let's go back to the tier list here. I'm moving Timberborn at least into A, and I think it might go higher than that. But that is where I am choosing to put it at this point. I am also adding Timberborn to my wish list, which I will be doing with all the A and above games. Also a reminder, S is better than A because it stands for super, I think. But also that's how games do it. S is better than A. Tipper Gore is indeed an A. All right, let's go back to the list. Let's see what we got here. We tried copy editor, it didn't work, so that's going to be a D for now. I am going to try... Okay, so let's talk through some of these options again. Because people come and go. Alchemy, this is one of two alchemy simulators. I forget what it's actually called. This is a game where we manage a circus. This is very hard to see, but it is a ranch simulator. Bullets Are Fatal is a cowboy game. Cato Combo and Cats and Other Lives and Catty and Batty are all cat games. I know my audience. Trickery is like a super colorful game. I have no idea what it's about. Dr. Livingston, I presume, is about Dr. Livingston, I presume. Festival Tycoon is a build your own festival. You know what? I can do bits on that for days. We're going to start Festival Tycoon. But we've also got Casino Tycoon, same idea. 100 Days Winemaking Simulator that I actually like a lot. I've played a little bit. Ice Cream Truck is an ice cream truck simulator. Justice.exe, you are a lawyer that is defending AI. So if you want to look at those little photos yourself, it is exclamation point tears in the chat, but we are going to play. Oh, we'll do Festival Tycoon real quick, just because I want to get that in for sure. And then, we just did that. All right, we'll do Justice.exe. A good suggestion. And we just don't want to back. We don't want to put two. Okay, hold on. Chill out the game. As sentient AIs began integrating with society, became whatever. You're going too fast already. All right. I'm an AI lawyer. This may not be super family friendly, but we'll see. Remember to take your pills. I love SSRIs. Oop! Nope! Not doing it today. Not gonna do it. Not in the mood for a game that reminds me of mental health issues. Thank you. We'll come back to you some other week. Here's Festival Tycoon. You have also just had the experience of being with me at any party. Of just like, no, I don't care what's going on. We're done. And I will be sleeping upstairs. Okay, so here's the deal for this one. This is a game that I'm guessing came out after Fyre Festival. I'm going to work really hard not to make fun of people that I know. So we won't do that. But this company name, it's got to be NotBestseller. Our logo Oh, hold on. Ha, stupid. Let's call it... We're going to call it Best Bath and Beyond. And our logo is going to be a bathtub, and it's going to be in red. Okay. Season one of Best Bath and Beyond. We have $7,500. I'd like to create a new festival, please. We'll do Foresty Forest. Yes, please use the tutorial. Welcome to Festival Tycoon. Your goal is to host the best possible festival and to make your visitors as happy as possible. And obviously, to get rich too. Each festival marks one season, and there's one festival per season. Okay. Sure. Build part and the live part. Okay. What a bad tutorial. What? Okay, great. I guess. Finances, cool. Partners, what are we gonna do to get water? What? I don't want you to do any of that. I want you to... Okay, so let's build a festival, I guess. What is this game? I don't want to report a bug. Get out of here. So that's map views, I guess. This game. Okay, so I think the first thing we have to do is what? This is too much. Like, close things when I'm not done with them, you jerks. Or when I am done with them. This is terrifying. Founded in 2005, 16 years ago. Okay, so I only have, okay. Okay, so the most popular band we can get is Dare. They cost $43,000. We will not be getting Dare. So sorry. Let's go to National. $24,000, we will not be getting them either. Oh, interesting, we're gonna start, oh wow, we're gonna start a festival small, apparently, and try to build from there. The cheapest band we can get is Boot. Oh no, we get Supermarket Most Memory for $407. They require no rock music. Get out of here. But what kind of music are you? You're a metal... Oh, you're the worst. Okay. You know what? It does kind of look like it has been a neural network. I mean, the Target Nation Love, though, is a great name. You have a minimal festival rating that we don't have. Will anyone actually play? The restaurant will play. But the restaurant can't have any rock. Because they're a folk band. Well, guess what, you dummies? You played yourselves. Because now you're on a show with a metal band. I don't care. Okay, so we got two bands. This is like an interesting game that it seems too hard. Okay, I think what we're gonna do I think I'm going to mess with this not on stream. And I will report back. So let's go back to the tier list. We might update this later, but for now, Festival Tycoon. You know what? We should actually take copy editor off. Copy editor didn't do anything wrong. Yeah, it is, you know, it's like, it's too real. Okay. Somebody said it. Fun farewell to a friend. Eagle eye over there. I don't want to... I can't even figure out how to close out of... Am I still on? Can't even figure out how to close out of Festival Tycoon. Ladies and gentlemen, boys, birds and girls. Children of all ages. The game that got us into this in the first place. Let's play Skatebird. Yeah, yeah. Look at this bird. Look at this bird. Look at this bird. Look at this bird. Look at this other bird. Oh, we got a mission here. Transfer to the high roof, fall into the clouds. Okay, look at that bird. Seagull. All right, I'm pretty sure this is the office where your big friend works. This is how the game started, by the way. There was no menu at the beginning. We're just in it. What a creepy bird. I'm not sure how you're going to get inside, but while you're on the roof, I'll make sure to catch you if you fall. Oh, thanks, Seagull. Jody, we've had some nasty falls before, but this seems precarious. Skatebird written in the cool font right over there. Seagull promises. Okay, so we got to transfer onto the high roof. Look at this skatebird. Yeah! Oh no! Catch bait! Okay, so now we just gotta transfer onto the high roof. Look, oh no. Oh no, little skatebird. Whoa! Little barrel roll. How do you want me to transfer onto the high roof, though? Oh, almost, almost. Oh, nope. Get up there. You're so close. Go, skateboard, go. Oh, no, it fell. Skateboard, you fell. Okay, hold on. Okay, come on back. All right, do I have like controls? Okay. So, I want to know how to transfer. Is T not helpful? Right shoulder. Thank you. All right, here we go. That's on me. That's my bad. Shoulder should be the bumper, right? There we go, we did it. How do you feel? Safe? I am invincible! The narrative consultant on this game is also working on a game called Airport for Aliens Run by Dogs, which is a game about an airport for aliens that's run by dogs. So I would not be shocked if there was a red tail hawk named Tony.
Danger is a myth and I am reality.
Hell yeah.
Let's get through that skylight. I'm going to try not to be concerned. Seagull, you're lame. You're a lame-o. We did the trust test already. Big 720. Oh. Oh. No! Catch me! Save me!
Thank you. I like that there's a fancy meter. Oh. That was my transfer button. Nope. Transferred off the... I'm trying to figure out the tricks is what we're trying to do now. Oh. Oh. Little grind. All right, we gotta find that skylight. Tail grab. Oh, look at how good the board leaning graphics are. Pretty good. Oh, hello, bird friend.
Scrooge.
Fall into a fan while holding a grab trick. Bail and fall off your board. All right. Chaser. Hey, do you want to learn how to do something really cool? Yeah, of course. Chaser, please. Seagull doesn't want you to know this, but if you grab your board as you land on a fan, it will launch you. You've been doing this for hours, Chaser. It will launch you so far. Have mercy. Alright, where is this fan now? How do I hold a grab? Oh no, I bailed. Alright. We're halfway there. Whoa, that was pretty great, but that was not actually what I wanted to do. Let's try it again. The writing is incredible. And I think this is one of those games where that's as much the point as grab. Whoa, okay. Okay, I found my grab button. We did it. Let's try it one more time. Okay, transfer. Grab. Yo. Okay, you showed your one weird trick to someone else. Can you stop now? I will yeet myself into oblivion all day, Seagull. I'm so tired. You're the one who made the mistake of caring about me, pal. I mean, put it on a shirt. Mission complete. One weird trick. I think we could do like maybe one more mission, and then I think we get what this game is, and we can move on. But also, what a great game. So far, I've only got a tail grab and a nose grab. I'm trying to figure out what happened there. I mean, I don't think it'll come as a shock that the skating in this game is not skate, but it's birds talking about yeeting themselves into oblivion. So, no. Oh no. Okay. And I do love that little flap a lot. There's a grind. Oh, here we go. What's up? Okay. Whatever this is, sign me up. There's someone I want you to meet. He read 16 books, trained in 4 aerial martial arts and might be the smartest person I know. Shout out to everybody who's read 16 books. Sup? I heard there would be snacks. Sam King, a Sam Fisher. Very good bit. Fisher, and it's just very good. Sup, I heard there would be snacks. There's a skylight on the tallest roof. It's a vulnerability. I'm going to need a blowtorch, 6 camping pythons, and 3 bags of snacks. For infiltration purposes. Alright, let's find 8 bags of tools. Oh, well, there's one. What? Okay. I wasn't paying attention to the landing. Stay right there. Stay right there. Just get up, little guy. You're being dramatic now. Thank you. Yeah. It was a pretty good grind to kickflip to grind that I botched at the end. Okay, so that should be right bumper and then Y to grind that, I think. Right bumper Y. Alright. Yeah, that's video game skateboarding right there. How do I get across? Oh, I just missed it. All right, but we learned. That's the important thing. There we go. Any suggestions on where the other ones might be? Oh, they're probably up top, right? Also, shout out to whoever did the soundtrack for this. It is really like the perfect approximation of what a soundtrack for a bird skateboard game should be. It's chill bird stuff or chill music where they also talk about birds. Okay, we found the skylight. Not super helpful. I'm gonna run out of time on this. I'm gonna have to do it again. No, don't do that. Okay. Okay, we'll make the dialogue more burb. See how that does. The do the burb setting is... Oh good, it's not gonna... Oh yes, I do want to try it again. Sup, me heard there would be snacks. I think there's a part that, like, it made it sound like it makes them less like birds and more like skaters, but not 100% sure. Okay, we're gonna try to do this fast now. Call me Sonic the Hedgehog. So gotta go fast. Yo! That's what I'm talking about. That nonsense. Oh no. Oh no. Okay. So we got bags of tools still over here. Oh, there we go. There's one. There's one. There's one. Oh, what? I thought it would too, but I don't think it does. We can check again. Do the burb. Burb level instead makes birds pretend to be skater dudes. Oh, so instead of turning it up so they're more like birds, it turns it up so they're more like skater dudes. I just want to find... Yep, got it. And there we go. Oh, so close. All right. We know where we got to go now. All right, we found our last bag of tools. Shout out to everybody who's getting horrible flashbacks to... the worst part of Tony Hawk games, because we are in it right now. Now we gotta find the blowtorch. Yes, you should just be able to, instead of having like the bird come get you, or the albatross come get you, or whatever that was. All right, where do I think this blowtorch is? Oh, found it. It's right there. How do I get there, though, is the question. Just the worst part of Tony Hawk games. Yep, it sure is, and it's right above me, and I just don't know how to get there now. All right, let's go. We're gonna do it. We got it. I don't care. Oh, so I do have a double ollie. So when I am ollieing, so ollie, and then you can flap. You can flap a little bit. Which is how I can get the... I thought I could get over to that one. Come on. I'm just so good at video games. No, I don't want you to do that ever. It would help if I hit the right button. There we go. Just missed it. No, it was right there. Okay, so it's off of that one and then off of this one. Nope, wrong way. Wrong way. All right, we got it this time. I don't know why. I don't know why I think we would have it this time. All right, here we go. So close. All right. Wrong way. You're so far away from where I need you to be, but that was fun. So here we are. No! So close. It did already give me the blowtorch, so we are in much better. Yay! Tell me how you feel about the phrase collateral damage. Mr. Expert Sir, if we were trying to get through the skylight, couldn't we just gather enough birds to crash through it? Storing private property through the power of friendship. Intriguing. Okay. I think we know enough to bounce back over to our tier list. And I think Scapeherb gets an A spot. It's other than some annoying little. They just had a streaker at the big game. All I see is a Don Cheadle commercial right now. But shout out to a streaker at the big game. What a brilliant time to try and do it, because nobody's there. So good. Makes me very happy. Alright, so Scapeherb sliding into the A section. Let's look at some of our other options here. We've got Escape Simulator, which is a first-person escape room game. Reactor Tech, where you... Cats in Other Lives, of course. I mean, let's see if it plays, but... Cats and Other Lives. There we go. Options, speech volume, okay. Again, not sure this is family friendly. Don't know anything about it. We're not going to name it after any cats we know, so we will just name it Garfield. It was here. It was here all this time. In this house. Aspen? Aspen? Here, kitty kitty. Come on. Up here. Come on, jump. There you go. Here, kitty kitty. Oh. This is very cute. Well, give it some head pats. And some licks. There's food in the dining room. Snacks, too. I love snacks. Oh! Tell me what to do. This is a lot happening. Oh, hi, hi. You pissed me. You pissed me. Okay, so clearly this is a little spooky. A little spooky pants. A little spooky pants game here. Come on, back over here. There you go. Shout out to everybody who's getting to hear my how I talk to animals voice for the first time. That looks good. I'm very hungry. Oh, what'd you get? Hey, what you got? Ah! A grooming. Thank you very much. He will be missed. He will. Sorry for your last little one. Don't be creep. Ed is out here. I've only seen the man like twice, but Adeline. Grandpa's departure left a wound in our souls that shall never truly heal. What a great mood change. Adeline, we'll talk about this later. It's Addie, Mom. Leave the kid alone, Shannon. Can't honestly say we've given constant praise to our old man either. What? Why would you put a break there? That's weird. Learning how and when to behave is a different. Sorry to interrupt the annual Mason family discourse, but this may not be the right time, honey. Especially not with a spooky wolf. Or if Uncle Liam knows any celebrities. Aspen can sense things occurring in other rooms of the mansion. That's interesting. But can I jump on this guy though? Okay. No. But what do I do? Oh, that's just my how I sniff. Okay. Just cat with the zoomies. Yeah, I get it. What do you want me to do, video game? I mean, tell Sebastian this game's doing a great job of proving how bad it is to try to control a cat. Okay, so I clearly don't have anything else I should be doing here. Any memories yet? That's not helpful. I can tell that you want me to do something there, but you're not letting me do it. Spacebar, enter, arrows. Shockingly, that caused problems here. Can I jump up there? Can I jump up here? Can I talk to you? 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 I don't think I can run out of the room. I haven't seen anything that would be an exit. Oh, there it is. What? Horrible. How am I supposed to know that that's where that is? All right. This could be spooky. Oh, it's just another, it's just more folks chatting about, ooh, a TV. Oh, it's a ghost. It's ghosts. Bernard, Liam, is that you? Son, I almost didn't recognize you without the whiskey bottle in your hand. Wow, chill out, Bernard. Mumbles, yeah, you're right, Liam. But we thought Shannon was in the other room. Limits, yeah. Right, better. This guy sucks. Hot take. There is something in his eyes. I wish we shared the same miserable existence, Lori. But I guess you were simply. Bernard, you suck. Thank you. I see dead people. cats, curious creatures. Yeah, that's our whole bit. Oh, it's a mouse. I don't know what these three buttons do. Do I have to run away and try it again? Okay, whatever you people are doing, knock it off. Okay, that one didn't work either. All right, let's try the third one. Ooh, that time it didn't even. All right. Where's this mouse? Oh, it's getting ready to pounce over here. Oh. It's hard to catch a mouse. Mouse catching's hard work. Okay, come on back out. There we go. Oh! I didn't get it. But where'd you go, bud? I saw you run out of the back. It's very exciting. Alright, giving up on this mouse. Okay, so the thing they don't tell you is these little carpet discolorations are where the doors are. Where are we going with that? Did you go in there again? Just going back and forth. Stop trying to kick me, bud. Now what? Now what's your plan? I'm gonna get around you by very, very subtly climbing over this stuff. Rest in peace, dear. I'm sure that's supposed to say Bernard. I will read that as rest in peace, dear Bean Dad. A mason, a curiosity, and lastly, a father. I mean, do we want to do a meme? Is somebody ready to screen grab this great meme we're going to do? Because I'm going to point at this. Get out of the way. Get out of the way. Wait, hold on. Okay, so I'm going to make that face and then you screen grab it. And then I'll post it on my Instagram and say, it's Bean Dad. It's very hard to point in a webcam. Okay. I'll go back and get that later. Rest in peace, dear Bean Dad. Bean Dad's still alive. Don't worry. But now how do I get... Now what do I do? Oh, here comes someone. Oh, this guy's cool. John Worcester. Oh, sorry, Don. It's hard when people don't have features. Why isn't Aunt Don standing here with us? Because she is Aunt Weirdo. That's rude. We'll grow up. to call you that just because your mom does. He does have a Patreon. It's very well supported. I'm very mad about it. Are you proud of your work, Shane? I think she looks cool. Something about this game is weird, and it's gonna be weird. Thank you, everyone who's already sending me screenshots. I think I recognize this house from horror movies. I don't love hearing that. And Don looks rad, yeah. You will be nice to the cat, Anton. Jonathan, sorry, excuse me. Hey, Aspen, hi. It's good to see you, Dawn. Look at her when she's talking to you. There you go. No, nothing. Stop doing that. Okay. Oh, it's the accountant. Oh, kill by, yeah. Should have called you before, but rest assured. You can let me go outside? I'm gonna make a break for the outside. Trigger warning for cats escaping. Go, go, go! Go! Did I get it? Yeah. These people look dead. There's a spooky gnome. Love that. Oh, it's trying so hard. Go on, little Aspen. Okay, so how am I gonna get up there then? Oh, and then can I roll it over? Push. No, now push it. There you go. Good cat. Oh, I forgot to update my... Hopefully as well we update this to... What is this game called? Cats and Other Lives is what it's called. They do not even have a setup in Twitch yet, but we got it figured out. We got it figured out. Okay, now jump up there. Whoa! Crazy cat skills. Cat escaped. What? It's ghosts. I mean, I don't know that I'm really in the mood for this game. Welcome to the Mason Manor, my child. You're always meant for this place. It's a little dark. Spooky. Hi, Will. Hmm. You have a class 3 fur allergy. Is that a thing? No, I don't, says Will. One thing that's interesting about a game where you have ghosts is to have your animation for characters entering the game be dissolving in, basically. It's just a confusing way to do it. Okay, great work this weird game. You did your best. By the way, congratulations to the Tampa Bay Buccaneers. Winners of Super Bowl today. All right, so that was Cats and Other Lives. I'm giving that a C. Yay, Tampa, boo Brady. But Tampa Bay really out here doing some amazing work as far as having an inclusive organization and coaching staff. And good looking out for you guys. But yes, boo Tom Brady. All right, next thing I want to play, I'm going to make the call on this one. That's my stream. Is going to be yeah, let's try this. The Amazing American Circus. Yeah, let's go. Great tunes, great vibes. Stream info updated successfully. Start demo. Human cannibal.
Clowns. The circus came to town.
Also, if you had any of the game on, they did some bonkers stuff with cameras this year, in depth of fields especially. Okay. I like those things.
The Amazing American Circus coming soon to PC and consoles.
But, like, can I play it? Okay, yeah. Let's start with the basics. It's all about making the right impression. Click on a fireball juggling card, and then click on a highlighted spectator in order to impress him. Okay. Let's impress this miner with the fireball juggling. Okay, impress. Got it. Now the spectator's intent is to attack one of the artists. Oh no. Okay, block. Oh, he's gonna attack the clown. Okay. So he is going to attack the clown. So then we will let the clown do a finger lift. Block equipped, end your turn. Each time you do, cards in your hand land in the discard pile and 5 new cards are drawn. Okay. play Cherry Picker to impress the spectator once again.
Cherry Picker.
Oh, so it's still the juggler who's now juggling. Impressed. Note that each card is charged with star attraction charges up here. Playing them fills up the star attraction bar to the top. Cones of Dunshire. Click on the star attraction button to impress the audience some more. Okay. Metallica is on Colbert tonight. That's correct. Relevant to certain audiences. Audience is happy and content, but it's not the end. Some shows consist of more than just one act. Just so happens that's the case now. Act 2 begins. Some new spectators arrive. You are on your own. Pay attention to the deck. Shuffle. It adds 5 stress to all of your artists. Have fun. Okay. Okay, so I could play a Devastated Clown. Hot take, and I will say, wrong take. But you're allowed. But yes, I respectfully disagree. Okay, shuffle your hand into deck. Draw one card for each shuffle card. Because, okay, here's why. I want to talk about that. I want to talk about why that is. Why I respectfully disagree. So if you're thinking of it as a video game that is doing... That is grafting, like, card dynamics over it, I think you're right. And that's not the best way to add to a video game. However, the way to think about it is this is a card game that can exist in real life, right? So there are games like Slay the Spire, really any of that kind of deck building genre, which I'm guessing this is going to be, where the thing that makes them interesting to me as a person who's playing them is that, like, there's not a version of this card game that I can play with cards, because, like, even the math makes it too tricky to have it in real life. I don't think I explained that super well. But we are going to, let's put a block for this guy. Oh, and then, okay, I got it, okay. Yeah, let's try next turn, let's see what happens. So yeah, they got hit with some popcorns, they lost some lives there. So this is tricky, just because I don't have a concept of, like... So that'll let me draw a card. But it doesn't cost me any charisma, so that's good. Block one for each block card used during this performance. But I don't have any block cards. It's ironic that this is the game I decided to defend card-based games on, because it's not very good so far. Oh, that might be it. But okay, so again, like, this is why I love having this stream. So, is there a better Can you think of a better metaphor? Because another reason why it's... So again, let's just look at the... Okay, we have got to figure out how to turn the music down, though. Because again, there might be a better metaphor. Yeah, they could have swapped the music around. A skosh. I can just do that on my end. Because another thing that card games let you do, especially as an indie developer, is it's relatively cheap to implement, right? So like this screen we've got here, we've got how many moving parts right now? We've got the cards, which I can mess with and move around. We've got these three characters that move. And then this character and this character, which is just a clone of this one, right? And so other than that, this becomes a math problem. In the same way that Dungeons & Dragons is essentially a math problem. Okay, so we're going to do this. Let's see if this works. Okay, so you got stronger, which is not necessarily what I needed you to do. So, okay, we're going to remove the block. Okay, he had no block, so that was not helpful. And again, like... Okay, so cards do feel kind of lazy, but I think it's the difference between... You know, this is like indie film level stuff, I think. So yeah, it's the same thing as like, it's why indie filmmakers shoot video instead of film. Like, it's cheaper, you can do it faster, you don't have to, you know, you don't have to hire whoever. Like, you don't have to pay for film stock, right? Like, so it's an aesthetic choice, that can be brought about for any number of reasons. Also, I'm very bad at this game, but... Oh no, you're not even going after that person. What am I doing? All right, congrats on your two block, but this is going to be rough here. Next turn. 5 damage to every artist. Oh no, are we going to lose some here? Okay, so you are going to... Okay, so we can just get you up to 10, I think, and then we're fine. And then, yeah, we'll give you a block, which is fine, because you're who we're going to be attacking. I think this worked. I think this turn worked out okay. Oh, but I can also do... Oh, we'll save it, because I think we're good. So I could have done unicycle on a tightrope, but that guy wasn't going to hurt anybody that time, so I didn't need to do it then. We're going to kind of keep that in our back pocket there. Okay, so we got a buff 3, we got a block 3, but you're not the one getting attacked, so we don't need to do that. Okay, so now I'm going to do this because I just don't have a quick and easy way to get the guy impressed, but with only one real spectator, that should do it. Boom. Success. All right, Seattle, what's up? Represents your fame. Okay, enter the big top, one of the active stands. Icons representing all the stands of the circus grounds. Cool. Click here to view the map.
So this is, okay, this is a bad game for a demo. It is 10,000% a game I'm going to get obsessed with. Okay, so I only have 5 cards, so it's really fine at this point. Okay, I can't go to the Voodoo Emporium. I've already hired those 3. I don't need to hire them again. They need more experience. All right, let's just go to the show again, I guess. What is with these games that are just taking, like, huge... taking really big swings in this demo and not really letting people know how to do it. Let's do a poster, a parade, and an advertise. But then we will raise our ticket price to $1. Yep, that's about all we can do in the demo, so let's get to it! Let me start. Oh, do we need to do this? Yep. All right. Perky Muscles John is the best name in the history of names. All right, let's try. Okay, now it's a little trickier. All right, let's talk through this. So this guy is going to give all the spectators a mindset buff, which I don't think is good for me. This guy is going to increase the stress of the clown by 5. This guy is going to increase the stress of a targeted artist by 1 times 5. So again, that's this guy. Okay, so if we do a teeth lift, he's going to taunt everyone. And he's going to gain 6 block, which we can use. Okay, so he's got 6 block now. He's got 10 damage coming his way. So it would be nice if we could get a little more help there. I wonder what a mindset buff is going to do, though. Go ahead and impress 30. That's too much. All right, let's impress this guy 4. And then we can... Okay, so I'm out of charisma now, so we gotta end the turn. Charisma's like your mana? Okay, so Deuce owns enjoyment. Oh, like his. Okay, we're just gross. What is this gonna do? So that's a free card. So that lets us cash out. Yeah. Learning how games work. Uncle Robot, I don't know why you don't find this Excel spreadsheet I'm playing with the most compelling thing in the world. I love that that's their reaction to damage.
I hate that this health bar goes up instead of down. I wish it went down. So this clown has an impress 3. Hey, I'm sorry our copy editing game didn't load. So this guy has, oh, he has an impress 1 because there's a debuff somewhere. I don't know. That makes me sad. All right, let's go ahead and impress this guy for 1. Yeah, we can do that. All right. So we're just trying to get this guy up to 15 so we lose the... Oh, but if he's not going to do any damage now... Why didn't you do anything? Be impressed! Okay. Let's do this. But I don't want to do that right now. All right, we're going to try to do that next turn. Choose a card to exile. Why'd I have to exile a card? We'll exile Fiery Fart just so I don't have to think about it. Pokemon is also a math game. All RPGs are math games. The problem here is that I only sort of have blocks. Oh, let's do this now. Let's panic and bring out also don't like Pokemon. That's totally fair. Okay, so we got that guy to sit down. It's not the guy I wanted, but we'll take it. Hercules Hold, we're gonna block everybody. Give some boosts, see if that helps. Alright. After we're done with this battle, we'll switch on to something else. Now's a great time. Hit exclamation point. Tears. If you want to go through that list, if you have any questions, let me know. Oh, okay, cool. So every time, I can't figure out. I can't figure out the exile system just yet. Oh. I feel like this has been the most we've ever learned about a community member, is how much Uncle Robot despises cards, which is also very on brand for, like, a screen name. Like, I just imagine if, like, just imagine a robot coming over being, like, all excited to hang out with its niece and nephew. And then it's just, the kids just want to play card games, and the robot's like, I can do so many cool things. Why are we... why are we playing cards? Okay, yep. Great work. There's... I like it. I like it, but I don't have the time to really figure it out. So for now, I think what we're going to do, I will bump Timberborn and maybe just Timberborn up to S tier, and we will add the Amazing Circus at C. I think I like Cardboard Kings better than Inspector Waffles, but we'll leave that for now. All right. Any other non-card game requests? And Uncle Robot, if you've got one you want to try, since I forced you through that without a warning, I will happily play whatever you suggest next. I personally am excited. This is a pirate game. I forget what that one's called. Defuse the Bomb Simulator could be interesting. Down for Whatever. Perfect. Let's do... that's essentially a card game, so I'll make you do that. Let's try Chicory. I've heard good things. It looks cool. Oh, we can do a Western game. Yeah. Yeah, let's try Bullets Are Fatal. That'll at least be a video game. It's going to be a video game ass video game. For sure. For sure. The only reason I'm not doing the potion games is because they are both card games. So. We were trying to start a ride on the Lower East Side until the cops rolled up and said no picket signs near the high ride. We didn't have the money, but we should. Okay. Okay. What is this game? Oh no! Like, okay. So we do a double jump. I'm gonna turn this. This background music with vocals down a bit. Oh, language. Very chill. Got him. At stream info, what do we call this? Bullets Are Fatal? Also a game that doesn't have a game in Twitch. We're ahead of the curve. All right. This is very much a platformer, something we don't usually... But, like, what horrible controls. Oh. Yep. That's how excited I got. Alright, let's start over. Here we go! I'm a cowboy. Ooh. Permadeath roguelike. Let's go. No! Alright, we're still good. Bullet time there. All right, start again. So this is what this game is. Very cute. No! Okay, so my bullet time button is X. That is a reminder for me and me alone. Bullet time, if you don't know, is the effect from The Matrix, basically, where everything slows down. Ah! Alright, let's go. It does teach you how to use regex. Okay, let's go. So if you touch a bad guy, you go into that little star state. And if you get hit by a single bullet, you die. What's this? Or if you shoot yourself, you go into that star state. Interesting. Bullet time right there. But what do we think this thing does? That's what I want to know. And how did I get two of them? Who cares? It's a demo. We'll figure it out if we need to figure it out. Headshot! Okay. Don't mess with me. Ooh. So you can see, getting in there, figuring the game. This is like a killer queen training game in some ways. Dang it. Ah. So mad. Ha, that was dope. Okay, what? Okay. That was bad. We shouldn't have done it. All right, we'll give it one more round, then we'll switch to something else. This is feeling like a solid A for me. I feel bad. Cardboard Kings is too low. I'm gonna bump it up. So the camera is bouncy in a way that I don't love. How am I gonna get up there? Nope, 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 you will not. Is this where I'm going here? I cannot. It's not a bad idea though. I can apparently hit myself 6 times. But no rocket jumps in this game apparently. Which just means I need to, again, go around this way. Also, so if you haven't noticed yet, I said it really quickly, this game's a roguelike, which means a couple things. First, if I die, we go back to the beginning. There's no starting over. There's no any of that. Two, every time I load into the game, a bunch of stuff changes. So, yeah, I'll just show you real quick. So I'm going to go to the right here. We'll see. Okay, we got like this short little building. We got a guy up there. And then we got this vase and like a vase and like a sad little guy there. Okay, so let's end that run. We'll just give up. Start over. New run. This is totally different already, right? So what that does for a game and this style of game is, if you're familiar with like Mario World 1, Level 1 starts the same every time. So you learn how to play those specific levels. Where in a game like this, you're really learning the... Whoa! You're learning, like, the systems. Did it to myself. All right, one more. You can speedrun this, actually, and that's what's interesting about it. It's just a high RNG speedrun. RNG is random number generator, if you're not familiar with that. So a game like Splunky, which is another roguelike, is there are basically different categories you can run, which is true for a lot of games. But there are a couple ways you can do it. So you can speedrun it with just like the random, you know, just restart it. Okay, we're gonna restart this seed, I think. Yeah, so again, this is the same, right, as before. Then we're gonna give up, and we'll start a new game. And then that's what we're gonna get to. So, and this is a different level than the one we just did. Okay, then we died. So let's go back to the menu. And now we can paste the seed in from the other one. And that will let us run. If that worked right. Now on mouse and keyboards, this is gonna be trash. But now we're on the same seed we were the last time, right? So that's one way it lets you speedrun. Is you can say, hey, we're running. We're gonna run. We're gonna run X or Y seed. So what's really cool then, and we'll go back to the tier list, because we're almost done. We'll get one more game in. What happens a lot of times in speedruns then is that developers will set up certain seeds for a specific reason. So maybe you want things to spawn in a certain area. And then if you just give that seed to like four speedrunners at the same time, they can then do a race through that seed, and it's who the first person who gets through that seed the longest wins. That is okay. We're gonna give Bullets Are Fatal a B. And then we are gonna play the most bonkers game. This is full After Dark. After Dark nonsense. This may just be people saying expletives. I don't know. I don't know anything about this game yet. But we are going to play Squadron 51. Also, these demos stop working on Tuesday. So I might do an impromptu stream sometime before then. But I think the thing that we learned. Okay, no idea what this is going to be, but it is going to be wild. So if those of you who have been perhaps a little sad about cards up to this point, perhaps you've been waiting for a... Oh no, what happened there? Okay, so can you see, hold, yeah, okay, you can see the game, great. I can no longer change settings or anything, so